After a century and a half away, 13 stolen Ethiopian artifacts have returned home. The items, according to officials, are part of the largest act of restitution in Ethiopia's history, repatriated following months of negotiations. They were put on show in Addis Ababa at the weekend, at a press conference with Tourism Minister Nasise Challa.
Our country's ancient civilization, history, artifacts, fingerprints of indigenous knowledge, culture and value have been looted through war and smuggled out illegally. At this moment, countless treasures of ours are found in various countries' museums, research institutes and in the hands of individuals.
These particular items, including an ornate processional cross and a richly coloured triptych depicting the crucifixion of Jesus, were taken in 1868, after the Battle of Magdala between the British and Ethiopian empires. Tevfik Meles, Ethiopia's UK ambassador, said many of the treasures were located in Britain.
It was not possible to return all of them. However, these treasures are the biggest so far in number and in kind. This is the first time this quantity of treasure is returned home.
But the work is far from over. Tefri said Ethiopia is negotiating with the British Museum for the return of 12 tabuts. They are replicas of the Ark of the Covenant and are sacred in the Ethiopian Orthodox Church. British museums have long resisted campaigns for the return of artworks, often citing legislation that bans them from disposing of their collections. But pressure has increased, and last year the British Museum said it would loan some works to Nigeria for a new museum due to open in 2023. The restitution also comes as a conflict between Ethiopia's federal government and the Tigray People's Liberation Front continues to rage. Tefri warned that cultural artifacts are being destroyed and looted in the fighting, saying that without the treasures, there is no history. And without history, no nation.